29 days. Live from the Busch Light Studios.
I love Arkansas. I love everything here. Give me that thing here.
Your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
And this one belongs to the Razorbacks.
Streaming live from
HitThatLine.com.
Go crazy at Bob Walker! Go nuts!
This is Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious...
Your Razorbacks are 2021 SEC champions! And Bob Walker Stadium is an insane asylum.
I have been waiting for this moment for a long time.
Judging by the sound of it, so has everyone else.
All right, hold on, it's almost halftime.
Hey, how's everybody doing today? Live and alive and on location at Hardee's in Springdale. So come on out and see us here. We're at 401 South Thompson. This is... the chance, one of the last chances, in fact, qualified for the Hardee's Thickburger Eating Contest and a chance to enter the football trip of a lifetime. That would be August 21st, the big eating competition between all of our qualifiers that have downed a third-pound Angus Thickburger in 90 seconds or less. And the winner on August 21st gets tickets and the things that go along with it for the Cowboys and the Chiefs at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Phil Elson with you, Drew Barrett. We are live in Springdale at Hardee's. Matty T holding down the fort in the fort. And smells like lunch here at 11 o'clock in the morning, doesn't it?
Smells pretty good. Excited to hopefully see some more people qualify. We still have plenty of spots left in the qualifier, so don't worry if you think, well, there might only be one or two spots. Now, come on down, try it out, and you know, well, if you can't beat that time, maybe your time can still beat mine because I might still try it.
Drew told me
I have to use the tomato, and I don't want to do that.
If you don't want to taste something, you just hold your nose. That's what I was told a long time ago.
It might be hard to eat that big of a burger with one hand.
It really would, and I'm not holding your nose for you. This is the first time we've ever done a live show remotely together. We're still in our early stages, our infancy of doing this, so I'm not ready yet to put my hands on your nose. No.
It's a clean nose, Phil. I did wash my face this morning.
Well, good.
Hey, guys, I have a question.
Sure. What's your
question? Somebody comes down there and takes on the 90-second challenge to eat a thick burger, is the thick burger free whether or not they finish it?
That is correct. It is free.
Okay, because I know there's also a deal today that it's buy one, get one free thick burgers also.
That's exactly
that
right.
That is also correct.
Buy one, get one free at this location
in
Springdale, or is it all
that's
the locations?
That's all area
Hardee's
locations.
All the locations across northwest Arkansas. I believe that includes
Salisaw
and the River Valley as well. So, hey, this is your BOGO chance. Buy one, get one free. From 11 until 1 o'clock at any Hardee's that you're probably listening to on this station.
Technically, you could try to qualify here. Then you can buy one, get one free. You could have three burgers for the price of one.
If you're able to stomach all of I say go for it.
Well, the other two you can save for later, you know. Maybe have yourself supper and then one for your girl or something.
It's like I told you.
Bring home dinner for the lady.
I told you yesterday, and I'm still kicking around the idea whether or not I want to do this or not. I can make a burger last 2 hours.
I know you can.
I've done this before. If you're going to bring it back for the missus, for anybody that has a real missus or a missus that wants to bring her one back to a mister, how long are you willing to let that burger
sit in its
wrapping before you get it over to your loved one or your hungry one, for lack of a better term.
A few hours. I mean, I think anything over the two-hour mark is when I start to get a little iffy about something that's been sitting out.
So the 2 hours of this show would be just fine?
Just fine, If you sit here and you nibble and bite it like a horse trying to and just barely getting a bit on it for 2 hours, I think you'll be fine. Now, I will be disgusted the entire time. But you do you, Phil. I'm not here to judge.
That's okay. And again, I got to figure out whether or not I'm going to give this a shot. But the people already are coming in for their lunch. Beautiful smells. I brought this up yesterday. We didn't really dive into it very much because it's still summertime, right?
It is.
We actually have quite a bit of summer left. And the smells of summer, what do you associate with the smells of summer. I'm talking things that you don't smell at all during the winter time.
Okay.
You know, I mean, and I would say fresh cut grass would be one of those.
That would be.
You start to smell that a lot in spring too, but you got to be out there what, once a week or something if you're a homeowner or a renter that has to take care of your own lawn. So the fresh cut grass certainly is a top of the list smell for me.
Sunscreen. Definitely number would be.
Is that a good or a bad smell for you? Because some people have a pretty visceral reaction to it.
It's a good smell because I know I'm not going to burn.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I'm one of those people that if I get that first good burn in at the beginning of the summer, I can just barely do any sunscreen and never get burned again. My skin toughens up. It does it well. But the problem is I don't really want to do that one big burn. I know that it'll be beneficial to me later throughout the year. It's just getting through that pain of having to try to go to sleep with a massive sunburn
around
my shoulders.
And then the enjoyment of your skin peeling off for the next couple of weeks.
Yeah,
sunscreen is definitely one of those smells of summer. The ocean.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe there's some people involve the ocean during wintertime, but let's just be honest here. How often are you hanging out on the beach during the winter? So I'd say the ocean would be one of those smells of summer.
Yeah.
For me, and I don't experience this as often as I usually did, is hot dogs and popcorn. Baseball smells.
Yeah, baseball
that
smells.
To me was a big smell of summer, along with, now keep in mind, I was at these minor league baseball parks for like 5-6 hours, a couple hours after the game too. Stale beer is a smell of summer too.
Mm.
The leftover stuff, the stuff that was spilled on the ground at a baseball park, the leftover nacho cheese. We always associate smells of this time of year and that time
being
of year
good
with the positive smells,
yes,
like it smells here inside Hardee's at 401 South Thompson here in Springdale. The smell of the grill is a lovely smell of summertime,
smell.
Right?
Yes.
It doesn't smell so good, you know, before you start cooking on it, though. This is what I'm talking about. Not every smell.
So you want me to think of negative smells that remind me of summer.
Okay. I had one of the stinkiest moments of my life that I had nothing to do with. My body had nothing to do with it. Anything going on in my car had nothing to do with it. Wednesday, driving to pick up my daughter at her sleepaway camp right outside Utica, Mississippi, one of the great cities of the United States of America. Going over the Yazoo River, I don't remember exactly the spot in Mississippi that I was located. I don't think it was very far from Yazoo City. And some people complain about the paper mill smell in Pine Bluff when you get there. Sometimes around Springdale, the chicken mills and all of that. None of that compares to whatever it was that I smelled at the bridge going from the west bank of the Yazoo River to the east bank of the Yazoo River. It was disgusting. That's a smell of summer, too.
That could be a smell. The worst, when I think of bad smells of summer, I'll give you two. I'll give you a combined smell, the smell of cut grass and sweat with a smell of humidity, because it takes me back to 2-a-days of high school football with zero shade, heat index of 113. Just because it hasn't hit 115 yet, that means we can still go out there full pads. The smell of stinky, sweaty pads takes me back to 2-a-days of summer. And
it's such an interesting way to look at it, too, because football's not a summer sport.
No,
really.
It's not. But it's.
But practice is a thing in the summer for football. And that's what's starting today at Razorback Stadium. 2:30
for
the first of 28 practices, 29 days before kickoff against Rice.
And another smell, it kind of goes into the same thing with this, with the high school football, Icy Hot. Always reminds me of the summer, and not because I needed it to do anything with my muscles or anything. No, as a freshman, the seniors thought it would be funny to rub Icy Hot on a 105 degree day in all the freshmen's helmets. And your forehead burning all through your chin strap, they put it in on our mouthpieces and everything. Just one of the worst experiences. Every time I smell anything that's close to Icy Hot.
I never quite got that.
Like, didn't they do that in Revenge of the Nerds in their
jocks? They sure did.
Yes,
that's not really a way to endear yourself to someone that's supposed to be a teammate of yours.
Well,
I'm sure this is still a thing that
it's
happens.
It's the hazing point of view.
Well, keep in mind, the whole view of hazing has changed quite a bit.
Oh, it
just
has. I was in a fraternity. I know.
Well, it
changed overnight.
Absolutely.
By the time that I pledged, by the time I graduated, it was two completely different things. I was a pledge for 8-9 months. Nowadays, you're a pledge for 4 weeks. and then you're in.
Well, and look, we had an entire college baseball team in Davis, California, UC Davis.
Yeah, I remember that.
This just happened. This happened a month ago. Their entire baseball team, the coaches, were put on administrative leave. It's all hazing. So I wonder if it was icy hot or some alcohol that was involved in that.
Probably a little both.
Some of those things end up going together.
Yeah.
877-377-6963 to get with us in the next couple of hours. We are live at Hardee's, 401 South Thompson in Springdale. Can you put down a Hardee's Thickburger in 90 seconds or less? If you do, then you are entered for the 16th annual football trip of a lifetime, August 21st. And if you're the winner of that, you get to go to the Cowboys-Chiefs game at Arrowhead in Kansas City later on in the NFL season. Your text coming up after the break. We got calls as well. Aaron Torres will join us. And Bo Marchant getting into the Steelers in the NFL with training camps getting underway. Halftime back after this.
The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Well, the thing about y'all's craft is, take someone like me. I know fence, but you've got to know baseball, football, all the different individual sports.
You do not have to know all that stuff. Just listen to Ty.
I knew that sarcastic comment was coming 10,000 miles away.
You've missed that, haven't you? Tell me you've missed that.
Don't miss the Morning Rush. Weekdays from 6 till 9. Only on ESPN 95.3.
Business is back, and your locally owned TGI Fridays is now hiring for multiple positions. For over 26 years, TGI Fridays in Fort Smith has been locally owned and a fun place to work, and we want you to come be a part of our family. Apply in person or message us online on our TGI Fridays Fort Smith Facebook page. If you've been out of work and are needing a job, or you're just looking for a career change, we have multiple positions available in the front and back of the house, and we want to welcome you to our family at your locally owned TGI Fridays in Fort Smith.
Get a 2-year price guarantee and a $100 Visa gift card when you make the move to Dish right now, only with World of Wireless.
It's a limited time. We're a premier dealer for Dish, but you got to call us 877-305-DISH or go to our website, wowfastinternet.com. Call us, come by, see us. We'll give you a demonstration of the Hopper 3 with its all-new 4K and voice remote and multi-screen sports bar mode where you can watch 4 football games at once. Well, and by the way, football's within 30 days, so it's time to get your new TV Dish system.
And one of the other great things about the Hopper system, Netflix integrated, Prime Video integrated, a lot of the streaming services, just a push of a button away.
And your doorbell camera or your camera on your backyard's integrated. You can see it on your TV. But you got to call us, 877-305-DISH. The $100 Visa gift card ends August 12th. That promo ends August 12th. You got less than a week to sign up. So give us a call. We'll get you installed this weekend.
All right, call WOW now, 877-305-DISH. That's the number to the local guys at World of Wireless, 877-305-DISH.
Pretend you're holding Hardee's new hand-breaded chicken biscuit.
Big breakfast.
Your fingers squeeze the fluffy, made-from-scratch biscuit.
Me likey.
You take a bite and taste the crispy, hand-breaded chicken.
Crunch, crunch.
That's been dusted in flour and bathed in buttermilk.
Hot hand-breading action.
You hungry yet?
Literally starving.
Get your hands on the new hand-breaded chicken biscuit from Hardee's.
Feed your happy.
Available during regular breakfast hours only at participating Hardee's restaurants. Price of participation may vary.
My name is Adam Gray. I have so far lost 32 patients to COVID-19, and I've consoled people who contracted the virus and gave it to a loved one who then died. And this is breaking my heart. A very large percentage of the people in Arkansas right now that are being hospitalized are under the age of 40 and almost exclusively unvaccinated. We need this to end.
Get your vaccination. Learn more at healthy.arkansas.gov. This message brought to you by the Arkansas Department of Health.
What matters most to your family can now cost less when you choose comfortable, reliable, and efficient natural gas heating, water heating, cooking, and clothes drying for your home. You make the right choice in today's environment. High-efficiency natural gas appliances can reduce your monthly costs. And right now, you can save even more with heating and water heating rebates from AOG. Visit AOGC.com today and get more comfort for less cost.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Hey, Surrey!
Yeah! For the first time, it's going down history, baby. New 3-6 Mafia.
Need a little bit more halftime in your life? Make sure to download the Eastside Liquor Halftime Podcast. Eastside Liquor in Fort Smith has the best deals in the River Valley on liquor, beer, and wine. Stop by 9390 Rogers Avenue in Fort Smith and make sure to check out their Facebook page for weekly specials. The Eastside Liquor Halftime Podcast is part of the Hit That Line Podcast Network and is available wherever you listen to podcasts.
Things to lay out for the show here today. Your favorite smells of summer. Make sure they're confined to summer smells. They can be good or bad because not everything in life is good. That's just a fact. It's also International Beer Day. B.E. from Clarksville was in here earlier today, and he asked, does that mean international beers in
like
the United States? Because an
import
somewhere else is a domestic in another place.
That is very true. So a Budweiser would be an import across the pond.
Isn't that funny to even think about the word
really.
Import and Budweiser in the same sentence,
is.
Drew?
Import sounds fancy, doesn't it?
Our resident Bud man here. So if we're going to go the international route, what's your favorite import beer? And maybe that's a difficult question for you because you're a Bud man.
Well, it'd have to be, I guess, one of the Mexican beers. Probably Modelo Especial or Dos Equis Lager would be my go-to like Mexican-style beers. I don't know. I've had many different types of beers. Like, yes, I drink Budweiser on the regular, but I'm also a big craft guy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I love trying different craft beers. So I've tried different beers from – I want to say I've had a beer from every state except for Alaska and Hawaii. I'm pretty sure I've had a beer brewed in every state in the continental United States. So
that's impressive.
I've tried a lot of different beers. But international stuff, you know, it's
that's funny.
Really
like I've visited 44 of the 50 states. I don't think I've had beer from 44 of the 50 states.
You haven't had a beer in 44 of the 50 states.
Pretty sure of it.
Okay.
Pretty sure I've not enjoyed a local brew from all of the 44 states. One of my favorite local brews in here, we're talking domestic stuff, isn't even made anymore. It was called Kessler.
Kessler.
A brew made in Helena, Montana that I think went away. Not around any longer. I like Smithwick. Some people call it Smithwick. Smithwick.
I've heard of it.
It's good. And the other one I like is Bass Ale. These are both British, English beers. And I like the Mexican stuff, too. Anyway, I mean.
I would say, you know, Guinness, but outside of it being in an Irish car bomb, I don't drink it. I'm not a big stout guy. It tastes like drinking thick soy sauce to me every time I have to try to drink a stout or something like that. I mean, I'm not trying to knock it. I know plenty of people love them a good pint of Guinness, but it's just not for me.
So every once in a while, you'd rather eat your bread than drink it.
Exactly.
Is the way that you're putting it. 877-377-6963.
Phil, on our YouTube stream, some more smells of summer. We had
are these
some
good or bad?
I think these are good, and one is, I guess you kind of tolerate it. One of them was coconut anything.
Yeah,
and
I'd go with that. Yeah. I mean,
that's
kind of
like,
drinks.
That makes me, yeah.
Coconut sunscreen, just cocoa nuts. That is a nice smell
that
of summer. Agreed.
We've already had grill smoke. And this one I thought of because we just had the roads paved here yesterday. Hot asphalt smell.
That's a good one.
I would put that in the not quite nasty category. There can be a little bit of a pleasantness to that.
I've got a swimming pool right outside of my apartment door. And so every
chlorine.
Day. Yeah, the chlorine, exactly.
Yeah.
Yep.
I thought of that one during
the break. And since it's been, you know, we went a year without having the pools open there. It's like now I really notice. It's like, oh, there was a smell I haven't smelled in a while.
Barbecue sauce, a smell of summer where you're from, Drew, in Memphis?
No, that's a year-round thing.
Okay, that's a year-round thing.
Yeah, you said it had to be just specifically summer. Like, a lot of people would associate hot dogs or brats or hamburgers, but I eat brats all year round. Like, I love me a good brat.
Okay, and you talk about Memphis year-round, too. It's going to lead me to my next thing here.
What am I supposed to talk about, Phil? I've lived here for 2 months. I lived in Memphis for 26 years.
That's right.
It's the only life experience I have to pull from.
And look,
unless you want me to talk about the last 2 months.
I was thinking about this earlier today. Clay had mentioned yesterday. He texted me. He said we should fine you for every reference to Memphis. And by the end of the athletic season,
it'll
finance our entire vacation.
It will.
For the entire office at ESPN Arkansas. We could take six people on a cruise with what that'll take.
So everybody's on board for that one but me.
That's right. But, I mean, I understand where you're coming from here. The nickname for – now, so let me start this over. Mm-hmm. I went – my first job in baseball, I worked for a team in Fayetteville, North Carolina, summer of 95. I had just finished my first year of college. I was a student at Indiana University, right?
Okay.
I was 4 years younger than anybody else that worked for this team, and I guess I talked about Indiana a lot because that's what they called me.
Yeah.
It's the only time I've ever had a nickname based upon a state, right?
Yeah.
Indiana. And I don't even associate with IU any longer.
I mean, you don't live there. You're not really from there.
I'm not a Hoosier fan anymore. You know, 2 years at the school, I was a fan for maybe 6 or 7 years and moved on in life. But they called me Indiana, and I kind of leaned into it a little bit. I was Indiana proud then. I feel like we could call you Memphis.
I'd be fine with that.
You would be okay with that?
I would be fine with that, yes.
Now,
because I would wear that with pride because I have pride in my
I want to call him M-Town. Hey, look, it's M-Town again.
You can call me M-Town. You can call me 901. You can call me anything you want.
We could call him 900.
No,
901. Yeah.
He's got to go 901.
The direction we'd have to go with it there. Well, as long as you can answer to it, because that's the thing you have to get used to.
Yeah.
Like the previous co-host, Matt Jenkins, the only reason we did a nickname for him is because we had two Matts.
Yeah.
You can't have two people with the same name on a show.
No, you can't.
But he wanted to be Big Sexy.
No.
He said, that's what everybody calls me back home. And I'd be like, well
I didn't
this
know
isn't
you
home.
Back home.
That's right. This isn't home, and I just can't do it.
No.
I can't do it at all. So we took a vote amongst our listeners, and I think, Maddie, didn't we go against the wishes of the listeners initially?
I believe so, because I think we had to mess the numbers a little bit. I think, like, it was like, what was it, Meat Mitts or something like that? or Sasquatch. One of those, I think, actually did beat it out. But
was it Beef Hands? Something
beef,
like that?
Yeah, something like that. Beef Mitts, maybe?
We went with SmackDown, which took hold.
Which is a good nickname.
He even passed that nickname on
to Mrs.
to
SmackDown.
His future Mrs., which is now really a future Mrs.
SmackDown and Mrs. SmackDown.
So I feel like he really leaned into it. And it's difficult to lean into a new nickname because a lot of times the nickname you get is because people are just effing with you quite
fun
a bit.
Of you.
So we're going to F with you a little bit.
So, I mean, I had a few kind of those effing with you nicknames in high school and just around some buddies, but I've never had a nickname that stuck. So
in order for a nickname to stick, a bunch of people have to call you.
Exactly. I mean, and Memphis is a very good nickname. I had a buddy who that I grew up with that went to school at East Tennessee State, and he was the only person in his entire fraternity that was from Memphis, and they had two Andrews, so they called him Memphis. So I get it. It's a good nickname.
Okay.
Well, and I'd be proud to wear it.
Texts are coming in here. Tim in Fort Smith smells of summer when summer rain hits the hot dirt. Yes.
That's
I think
smell.
We can identify that smell. The summer rain and spring rain smell the same. There's going to be a little bit of a difference. Like that first
spring. Well, it's just
spring.
The more humidity. And you can smell the humidity in the air.
Yeah. And the spring rains kind of always feel like optimism for the upcoming, for the blooming, and whatever
the
is in the next few months.
May flowers.
That's right. Now it's just, you know, darn heat, although it's been pretty nice here
in
Arkansas for
week.
The past few days. Shane and Van Buren likes, and this is on the International Beer Day, he goes with, well, he sends me a text here from beeradvocate.com, Chocolate Peanut Butter Porter, Horny Goat Brewing Company. But that's not international. Mm. That would be international
if
across the pond. But yeah, chocolate peanut butter porter. I don't, you know, I'm not drinking beer for a dessert. I understand it doesn't taste like a dessert, but when I see chocolate and peanut butter in a beer title, I'm sort of like
a little iffy,
leaning away from it.
I've told Drew this too. When you get like a flight of beer, if there's one of those types of beers in there, it ruins the entire flight.
Oh, it really does, because that's the one taste that really lingers and kind of ruins everything else. You kind of just have to have like an extra beer to kind of cleanse the palate a bit.
Mm-hmm. Text out of the 479 wants your nickname to be Memphis.
I'm good with it.
Here's a good one. Brandon in Paris thinks you could be the new Tiger Bait. I don't know if you're –
I'm not aware.
If you're aware of the old Tiger Bait.
Who was
I don't
Tiger
think he's
Bait?
Called into this station very often, but he's on a lot of other stations and dials, and he's probably the most reviled sports talk caller in the state. Maddie, would you agree?
I would say so. He did actually call into the Morning Rush when I first when I was producing that for a little bit. So he has graced these airwaves. And
he's been banned from other stations. I know that.
He's a very polarizing figure, and by polarizing, I mean about 99% of people absolutely hate his guts.
He's Tiger bait because he's a big LSU fan.
Oh, okay.
You would be the same for Memphis, so maybe we could have the two of you guys battle it out for a Thickburger eating contest. Let's get Jody, which is Tiger Bait's real name, up here, and you can get Memphis here with Tiger Bait, and they could go mano a mano and see if they could who can crush a Thickburger first. We've already had a couple of contestants. Did our first contestant win? Second one is lining up right now.
I was too enthralled with our conversation.
We're at 401 South Thompson Street, Hardee's in Springdale. Get out here, and if you eat a Hardee's Thickburger in 90 seconds or less, you qualify to enter into the Thickburger Eating Contest. 16th Annual Football Trip of the Lifetime is August 21st. And that'll be between all of the qualifiers. The winner who ever eats the most Thickburgers, I think in 5 minutes, will win the Football Trip of a Lifetime to Kansas City to see the Cowboys play the Kansas City Chiefs. So come out and see us. Plus, buy one, get one Thickburgers from 11 until 1 o'clock this afternoon at all the Hardee's locations in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, and in Salisaw. We're talking with Aaron Torres next.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? So you've got an oil change coming up? We'll help you find everything you need. Right now, you can get 5 quarts of Valvoline MaxLife High Mileage Motor Oil and an STP oil filter for just $28.99. And if you're an AutoZone Rewards member, you'll also get a $5 bonus reward. Get what you need fast and get the job done easier.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Start your job today at AutoZone.com. Restrictions apply.
Get savings on Pro Essentials at the Lowe's Just for Pros event, going on now. Save on select appliance special values. Plus, save an additional $50 when you buy two or more appliances, each priced $396 or more. Find more savings throughout the store at Lowe's, the new home for pros. Must ask cashier to apply discount in store. Online must use promo code. Can't be combined with any other discounts. See Lowe's.com for exclusions and terms. Valid 7/15 through 8/4. U.S. only.
With over 40 years combined experience, the team at the law offices of Craig L. Cook understand the definition of work, real work, working for you. Whether you've been injured in an auto accident, on the job, a victim of nursing home negligence, or need help navigating bankruptcy, Social Security, wills, trusts, estates, or family law issues, Craig Cook will go to work for you. Call us today, 479-783-8000. The law offices of Craig L. Cook, with locations in Arkansas and Oklahoma. We work for working people.
Hi, this is Melissa with True Grit Running Company. Each day, we see familiar faces who have supported us from the beginning because they see the benefits of an active lifestyle. We're also always meeting new customers who are taking their first steps towards making running or walking a part of daily life. We have the opportunity to share in their successes and help them achieve their goals. The people of Fort Smith and the River Valley are why we believe we were voted one of the best running stores in America. Visit us and see how we can help you. True Grit Running Company, 6808 Rogers Avenue, Suite B, behind Chick-fil-A.
Is this the right decision? Living with an aging parent can bring stress, uncertainty, and guilt. Ease those emotions and trust that they are safe and happy at Dalton's Place at Waldron. Living in this community improves the health, nutrition, and housing for your loved one, regardless of income. Private apartments allow your mom or dad to keep their independence while their health is always monitored. Contact us today to see if your loved one qualifies. Dalton's Place at Waldron, 520 West 2nd Street. Your well-being first.
When you want beer, you go to a bar. When you want top-shelf spirits, wines, handcrafted cocktails, and cigars, in an atmosphere benefiting a destination, you go to 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge. Try our new menu items including fish and chips, classic club sandwiches, Caesar and Cobb salads, or stick to your favorites, dine in or carry out. Enjoy our state-of-the-art air filtration system, 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge. Defining nightlife in downtown Fort Smith. Doors open at 4 Tuesday through Saturday.
NWA Gold and Silver has moved to a new location in Fort Smith at 4600 Rogers Avenue across from Med Express. NWA Gold and Silver is always buying gold and silver, scrap, bullion, and coins. Plus, NWA Gold and Silver buys and sells jewelry of all kinds. Diamond rings, wedding bands, engagement rings, earrings, and more. Bring in your gold or silver today to the people that pay the most and have the best deals. NWA Gold and Silver in their new location at 4600 Rogers Avenue across from Med Express in Fort Smith.
Needing your roof repaired? Ramos Roofing is a local company that has over 25 years of experience specializing in your residential or commercial roofing needs in the Oklahoma area. Ramos Roofing, a company you can trust, offering discounts to senior citizens, law enforcement, or healthcare workers, and assists in your insurance claims. Ramos Roofing, standing behind their work so you can stand under it. Call 479-420-9903. That's 420-9903. Ramos Roofing, working with you to build a better home.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Hey, Sonny! Hey, what's happening, Sheldon? The King back. I know y'all miss a pimp, right? Yeah, but dig, there's been a lot of hate going on, okay? So let me holler at you something. What's the ball? Hey, look at here, dog.
You might have seen me in the street, but Sheldon, you don't know me. When you holler, when you speak, remember, you don't know me.
Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
Little 901 music to bring us back.
No, that's actually Hotlanta. That's T.I.
Tells you all I know.
Kind of, that's that Hotlanta, ATL.
I expect that almost any rap that gets played on our airwaves now is going to be rap out of the 901.
That's former Cummins unit inmate T.I. Mm-hmm.
Oh, very yes. Good. So a local, that's a local product.
Local celebrity, yeah.
A little more local than Memphis, I guess. Aaron Torres joins us from the Aaron Torres Sports Podcast and Fox Sports Radio. A.T., what's going on? I missed you last week. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I did go to Memphis one time, drove through to get to Ole Miss. The only one of the few SEC cities I've been to is Oxford. But I heard a lot of Memphis talk coming in. Beautiful airport, beautiful drive to Oxford. Penny Hardaway might get a big recruit today. But that's all I really got on Memphis, Phil. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I got to start there. I mean, is the impossible going to happen? I mean, are they going to get Jalen and Bates in the same class? A 1-2 punch.
I thought you were going to say, is the impossible going to happen and Penny Hardaway is going to get to an NCAA tournament? But No, I'm kidding. No, Memphis fans get so mad at me. I mean, it's like the track record kind of speaks for itself at this point. I mean,
no, it does. I'm more of a realistic than a lot of people.
To answer your question, you know, it's crazy. So Jalen Duren, who's – so it's interesting, right, because both of these players are still technically in the class of 2022. Amani Bates announces a few days ago he's going to reclassify. Jalen Duren announces a final five. Jalen Duren's the number one player in the class of 2022, and the assumption is he's going to come down to 2021, kind of like Quinn Ewers play this year. In the case of basketball, it's a little different because this will allow him – to get to the NBA a year faster. And so it's fascinating. Everything seems to be trending there, and it's crazy because, you know, I heard this rumor about 10 days ago that both of these players would not only reclassify but play at Memphis this coming season. I didn't understand it because just with the way the calendar is structured, Amani Bates, which is the number two player in the class of 2022, would not be eligible for the next NBA draft. This other kid would. So I never really understood how they would both end up there, but that appears to be where this is headed. And I'll say this, you know, I was talking to somebody that's really plugged in college hoops the other day. You know, Penny Hardaway, you know, he said that year that he had James Wiseman before James Wiseman left. He said, I want all the smoke. Well, you get the top two players in the class in August for this season. You're going to get the smoke, Penny, and we'll see if he can deliver. But just a fascinating, fascinating topic, Drew. To see if this ends up playing out the way it is. By the way, that kid, Jalen Duren, will commit today. So that's the crazy element of all.
6:30 Central Time, I believe,
right? Well, Aaron, I saw that he's down to a Final Five. And, I mean, this doesn't involve Arkansas, but this involves something we've discussed quite a bit leading into student-athletes being allowed to profit off the NIL. You know, there was all this talk that the G League or, you know, this professional league for kids coming out of high school, or maybe the Australian Basketball League would be the quote-unquote end of college basketball. Well, now NIL, Duren himself said with NIL, that changes the equation completely for him, and I imagine it does for quite a few other possible incoming stars in college basketball.
Well, what it does is, Phil, in my opinion, it gives you all the benefits of college basketball, and the biggest benefit is the exposure. And you could sit here and say, oh, you know, nobody watches college basketball until March Madness. You know, Trae Young talked this playoffs about, you know, he was on national TV 30 or 40 times at Oklahoma. Until the playoffs this year, he was on national TV once or twice a year with the Atlanta Hawks. And so What it does is it accentuates all the best parts of college basketball, and it sort of eliminates the worst part, which is money. Now, you know, is Memphis or Kentucky or whatever able to pay what the G League is? You know, I don't know. I don't know if we'll ever find out the exact answer to that. But, you know, Quinn Ewers seems to think that he is going to make $1 million before he ever takes a snap as Ohio State's quarterback. So I don't think it's inconceivable to think that Jalen Duren or Amani Bates or any of the top basketball players going forward can't expect a lot of money. And so, yeah, Phil, I it's just another fascinating element. Now, look, from the basketball perspective, there are these alternatives. I think there's always going to be players that just say, I really don't want to go to school, I really don't care about school. But I think it makes it harder to justify when you look at the fact that the exposure that college basketball gives, the exposure that ESPN, CBS, Fox, the NCAA tournament, conference tournaments, it's just unbelievable and it's unmatched. And I think for the G League on the flip side, I think now, you know, they have a couple questions to ask. Do we want to keep doing this? And if we do keep doing this, you know, how do we actually, it's actually turned into the opposite. How do we counter college basketball? How do we get more exposure for these kids? Because, you know, we all watched the NBA draft the other day, and I don't think unless you're a diehard college basketball or a diehard basketball fan, you really know anything about the 3-4 kids that were drafted out of the G League program this last year. So it's a total game changer because, like I said, Phil, it basically NIL takes out the worst parts of college sports that everybody always complained about, while also kind of accentuating the best parts as well.
Yeah, and with the NIL, and something that I've seen a lot of people, a lot of fans on Twitter that are complaining about guys going here, guys going there, and saying that they're never going to be able to compete because their local businesses won't shell out the money. And am I wrong in thinking this, but most of the big NIL deals have all been national type of companies. So all been off of social media advertisement. It hasn't really been that car dealership or that restaurant that now we've seen some of those, but that hasn't been where the big money is going to come from. So does actual region and area of companies around really matter when it's mostly national money?
That's a great point, Drew. You know, I think with Quinn Ewers, it's obvious that's the case. With Bryce Young, Nick Saban's talked about it. I think I saw a report from ESPN that said most of it's national. Obviously, with the female athletes, the whatever the gymnast name is from LSU, it's the same there. You know, I do think, first of all, it'd be interesting to see if Jalen Duren chooses Memphis. It'll be interesting to see if he ever talks about name, image, likeness, and if he talks about what kind of opportunities were presented to him by Memphis specifically. Now, I bring up Memphis because it goes without saying that, you know, one of their big benefactors, FedEx, is right in that town. And I think most people believe that, you know, FedEx can basically do whatever they want to help Memphis Athletics if they're so inclined. And so if Jalen Duren chooses Memphis, one, I'm genuinely curious about, you know, how much he says name, image, likeness contributed to his decision. It's interesting because in his case, he has said over the last probably 8 weeks or so since it became clear that he was going to reclassify, that name, image, likeness wasn't his number one priority, that it was how to best develop for the NBA, and the addition of Larry Brown on the Memphis staff has certainly, you know, helped Memphis's pitch along with Jalen Duren and along potentially they might be hiring Rasheed Wallace here in the coming days if you're to believe reports. So it'll be interesting, I just think, because you know, one, does he say that name, image, likeness has anything to do with his decision? And then two, what we find out about what was offered to him or what he accepted or whatever. But you're right, Drew. I mean, so far it's been the national stuff. It hasn't been the local stuff. And I'll still say in general, I still believe that at the end of the day, most of these elite high school players, they're going to pick the places that are best going to prepare them for the pros. And usually those are the places that name, image, likeness is going to, you know, be effective. Like you're not going to go, if you're the Ohio State quarterback, you're not going to go to, you're not going to go home hungry at night. You know, you're not going to be rubbing nickels together to pay the bills or whatever. And it's the same with Alabama. It's the same with Kentucky basketball. It's the same with Duke basketball. So I'm curious, but it's a great point by you. It's a great point.
So last thing to touch on here with you, AT, You know, so we got football season coming up. You know, there it's always a season somewhere in college sports, but you know what it is now, 24/7 for the unforeseeable future is rumor season.
Realignment.
And you referenced it in your more recent Aaron Torres Sports podcast about the rumors coming out of Florida State and Clemson that they reached out supposedly to the SEC. Both schools said we didn't do that. I know, you know, Mark Ryan is someone that's very respectable who broke this rumor. But, you know, your point, and this is exactly true, you know, this is not the first rumors to come out since the whole deal with Texas and OU started as rumor and then became reality a week later. So this is just another thing we have to get used to. Sooner or later, though, these rumors, some of them turn into reality.
Well, Phil, you know, I think – There's a lot of layers to this, and thank you for referencing the podcast. You know, and you know, I really, if the Imani Bates news hadn't happened, I thought that that was the topic that was really going to be the biggest story of the week, which is, you know, a few things. One, I think with the Texas-Oklahoma stuff, I think last week was the sticker shock of, oh my goodness, this is really happening. Texas and Oklahoma just asked out. The SEC just voted them in. This week was kind of everybody picking up the pieces. And so what I think is interesting is, one, I believe the rumors because, as you said, so as an example, you know, Mark Ryan does pre and post game, you know, at Clemson. I mean, his sources at Clemson, I guarantee, are better than anybody at the national level. Now, might somebody have a better relationship with Dabo? Maybe. But his sources at that place are better. In the same way that, Phil, if you say something's going down at Arkansas – I believe you in a way that I'm not going to believe any national writer because I know you're on that campus every day talking with people, all that kind of stuff. And so I believe all these rumors because how they're coming out. I believe all these rumors because everybody that's not in the SEC and Big Ten right now are trying to figure out, hey, what are those two conferences' next steps? How can we make sure that whether we're an individual school, a group of schools in a conference, how do we make sure that we don't get left behind? But what's also crazy about this, Phil, is that I don't think there's any one thing that brings the rumors to an end, right? Like you go back 10 years ago, once Texas decided, okay, we're staying in the Big 12, we're not going to the Pac-12, become the Pac-16 or whatever, everything basically at that point kind of fell into place. Texas A&M went here, Nebraska went there. But once Texas decided to stay, like, everything stabilized. I don't think there's that one thing right now because, again, nobody knows what the next 5, 10, 15 years looks like. Now, maybe the ACC contract's too airtight. Maybe nobody can get out of it. Maybe the SEC doesn't want to expand. But I'm telling you, man, whether anything happens or not, and no matter what anybody says publicly, behind the scenes, everybody that's not in the SEC right now is basically trying to figure out what is the SEC's next step. Are they staying at 16? And if they're not going to stay at 16, how do we position ourselves to make sure that we're in good shape for whatever the future of college athletics looks like? So it's crazy, Phil, and you're right. The rumors are not going to stop. I think Greg Sankey coming out and even saying we're staying. I don't think that's going to stop anything, and it's not going to stop the other eight Big 12 schools from trying to figure out what's best for them. It's not going to stop the Pac-12 from trying to protect itself. So this is not something that just because we reach a certain day or time that we're automatically, going to go back to normal. I don't think this is slowing down anytime soon.
Yeah, it's going to be a long time until I think everybody can be at ease that we're going that where we are now is where we're going to stay. Aaron, real quick before we have to let you go, we are out here at Hardee's in Springdale giving people a chance to qualify to win Chiefs and Cowboys tickets this season by eating a third-pound burger in 90 seconds. You think you could do it?
How big is it?
It's a third pound.
Fully dressed, though.
Fully
you can't
dressed.
Take any of the things
tomatoes,
you don't like off of
onions,
it.
Onions, lettuce.
In 90 seconds?
90 seconds.
I mean, I feel like I could, but if I could, then it would be a dumb question to ask. So I think I could, but I don't feel great about it. You know, it's like asking me, do I think the SEC is going to stick at 16? I think so. I don't feel great about it. That's kind of how I feel about this burger. It sounds like something I could do, but if it was that easy, then everybody would do it.
That is true. We've had people succeed already.
I'm basically the Florida State and Clemson of the burger world right now. It's like, yeah, sure. We want to go to the ACC, yeah, but does the SEC want you? It's got to work both ways. So
I guess I'm the Clemson and Florida State of the burger world right now.
I just love you too much, AT, to compare you to ground meat, but I'll leave it there. Appreciate you, man, and your thoughts and your podcast. Of course, Aaron Torres, host of the Aaron Torres Sports Podcast and on Fox Sports Radio with us most Fridays. Have a great weekend, AT.
We'll see you next week. I'll be here, guys. Thank you.
You got it. Aaron Torres. All right. Hey, we're brought to you by The Fence Man. If it's time for new gates, maybe some fence repairs at your home, get a hold of The Fence Man. They should be your first call. They do it all, not only the large commercial jobs, they can also do the small residential repairs like a wood privacy fence, a vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, custom wrought iron fencing. The Fence Man is the only one to call. Plus, 18-month, same as cash financing, is now available. The Fence Man. If it involves fencing, The Fence Man does it. He ain't afraid of no work. Call 479-782-3936. And we'll wrap up the first hour of halftime right after this.
Attention, attention. Do you have a fifth wheel, travel trailer, or motorhome that you don't get to use as often as you want? Well, Breeden RV has a solution. Breeden RV wants to buy your RV. Due to the historic events that have happened over the past year, RVs are in high demand, and Breeden RV will pay you top dollar for yours. So push it, pull it, or drag it to Breeden RV in Van Buren today for your free appraisal and get cash in hand within an hour. Call Breeden RV at 479-262-2418 or visit them on the web at breedenrvs.com.
This is Bruce Stanton, Vice President and General Manager of Pradco Fishing in Fort Smith. Our number one volume lure out of our 20 fishing brands is the Bobby Garland Baby Shad. We make them by the millions in our facility in Fort Smith, and the Baby Shad is without a doubt the number one soft plastic crappie lure in the U.S. Fish it on a live jig head or underneath a float, and you'll find it's as productive as live bait. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Bobby Garland Baby Shad.
During the month of August, Frank Row Furniture is having a store-wide super sale. That's huge savings for everyone. Savings on furniture, mattresses, dining sets, and appliances. Frank Row Furniture is also offering discounts on cash and finance through Snap Financing. Only $39 down. You heard right, $39 down. Family-owned and serviced after the sale. Frank Row Furniture. 405 4th Street, Barling, Arkansas. Best seats in the house.
Better make some room in the history books, because there's a new chicken classic to write about. Try the new classic chicken sandwich for $5.99 from B-Dubs. And sink your teeth into juicy hand-breaded chicken, topped with pickles and mayo between a rich challah bun. Plus, it comes with fries and it's $5.99 for a limited time. Don't wait for that price to be history. Get here for the new classic chicken sandwich from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Available at participating locations for a limited time. While supplies last, taxes extra. Add-ons extra, delivery subject to availability. Fees may apply.
Are you in need of roofing repairs or maybe more? Construction Master Roofing, who has been under new management since 2019 with over 25 years of experience, is who you need to call. Estimates are free, and military, first responders, and medical workers receive 5% off. Construction Master Roofing guarantees their work, and the number you need to call is 648-8888 in the River Valley, and in Oklahoma, call 918-859-4714. Construction Master Roofing, the roofing company that cares and gets the job done.
Finding an assisted living or senior care facility is one of the most important decisions you'll ever make. Choose the best. Hope's Creek in Van Buren. At Hope's Creek, your loved one will be in apartment-style living, eating three home-style meals daily, and receive the care and services they need. The round-the-clock nursing staff monitors health needs in a secure, monitored environment. Plus, you can check on your loved one anytime with 24-hour access. Stop by for a visit at 2502 Fayetteville Road or check out Hope's Creek online at hopescreek.com.
Arm yourself against harmful insects. Head to Metters Lumber True Value for a two-pack of Spectracide Wasp and Hornet Killer for only $4.99 while supplies last. 20-ounce Jet Spray Aerosol kills wasps and hornets on contact from up to 27 feet away and even kills wasps returning to the nest. It's non-staining too, so you don't have to worry about accidentally getting it on the outdoor decor. Don't miss this bargain of the month along with other insect repellent at great prices at Metters Lumber True Value.
Congratulations, you're having a little girl.
At that moment, everything changed. Our hopes and dreams for ourselves were instantly replaced by our hopes and dreams for her. We got life insurance policies from Shelter Insurance, so that regardless of what life throws at us, we'll still be able to provide the world to her.
Shelter Life Insurance Company, Columbia, Missouri.
Ask Shelter Agent Phil Hicks about a free insurance review.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Find us on 99.5 and 1290 in Northwest Arkansas, 95.3 in Fort Smith in the River Valley, 96.3 in Hot Springs in Central Arkansas, 104.3 in Harrison and Mountain Home, and everywhere on hitthatline.com. Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
Hey, man, we've had three people crush the Hardee's Thickburger in 90 seconds or less in the first hour of the show. I feel like that's an accomplishment for us.
Yes.
For this show. We haven't eaten it.
Because people want to come and see us, and then they decide that they're going to try it.
We just got.
It's not the other way around. It's not they're coming to try it and then see us. We're the main draw here, Phil. This is why they call us talent.
Well, Wade WPS on YouTube wants to know, can either one of you finish a thick burger in 90 seconds?
Well, of course I can.
No.
There's tomato on it, and I can't do the tomato.
Does it count if I eat the tomato for him? Because I can't eat the thick burger in 90 seconds or less.
That's a good question.
But I could eat two tomato slices in seconds.
If he eats the tomato for me, does it still count?
Not if the listeners aren't allowed to do that.
I don't think teamwork is a thing in competitive eating. That is a true individual sport.
Well, I've told you, I've done an eating contest before at Burger Fest. In a city that will not be named because apparently I speak this city's name too much. And I did a decently good job. I think I got down like 7 or 8 sliders in like 5. And then like I think it was a 5-minute time limit. And I think I got down about 8. And
seems like a lot.
That was the longest 5 minutes of my life.
Those
weren't dressed at all, and that's what made it even harder.
That sounds like a lot of bread, too.
It was. It made it a lot harder because there wasn't any ketchup, mustard, nothing on it. It was just a patty and a bun, so it was kind of dry to get down. You know, you need some
that's the
moisture.
Way 7-year-olds eat them, usually.
Exactly. You need that moisture from the condiments to help everything go down. And so I feel like if I could have done that, I could do this.
Who would have ever thought the word condiment and strategy would go in the same sentence? And you actually believe what the person is saying.
It is.
It's a feat of eating, right? Would that be – Maddie, would you think we could put those – you know how I love mashing words together. Mm-hmm. Would a feat of eating be feeding?
And by feet, you're spelling it F-E-A-T.
Yes. Feeding with the two E's would be a whole different scenario.
That's a different conversation.
That I hope does not involve food.
We might have to get the authorities involved if that's what Phil is trying to talk about.
So I want to know what other people's best feat of eating is. What is your best feeding that you've ever done? I mean, one that stands out to me in a bad way. Mm-hmm. Summer camp. I don't remember the year. Would have been mid to late 80s. And my summer camp took a night trip to a Pirates game.
Yeah.
We sat in the outfield seats, right field, Three River Stadium. Nachos, man. And, of course, the pickled peppers that are ubiquitous, always there for free.
Yes.
You know, you could actually just walk right by not in today's age any longer, but back in the day, before everything was handed to you in a plastic cup and covered, you could just walk right by, grab a handful of jalapeno slices without any of the people in the stand looking and have yourself some fun. But I did order the nachos, and I told all my friends around, I guess I was 8 or 9 years old, I put a stack of jalapeno slices together about yay for those who are not watching on our YouTube stream because this is radio. What do you think? Is this 5 inches tall?
I'd say about 5.
That's it, like 2 Encyclopedia Britannicas.
Though this is these are 2 white pages if we're going to go in that direction.
Okay.
And ate them all at once.
Oh.
And I earned the undying love and admiration of all those sitting around me. And then they felt awful for me the next day when I never stepped out of the bathroom.
As it was coming out the other end.
Good thing this was a Friday night game because I could do that at home in my parents' house. Anyway, that's my feeding. I try not to do that very often.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that.
Try not to do that very often. But you need to come out here and try to qualify for the 16th annual football trip of a lifetime. The competition between all of our qualifiers is August 21st, and the winner, that's if you got to down as many thick burgers as you can in 5 minutes, the winner will get tickets and the accommodations to see the Cowboys and the Chiefs at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. But you got to qualify first, and this is not the last chance to do it, but we only have a couple of weeks until the actual real competition. And we are 3 for 5 at our Hardee's location
well
at 401 South Thompson in Springdale. Like we're batting 600.
Who are the two weaklings that couldn't finish the burger in time?
I don't remember their name, but one of them had a really large beard. I thought he was going to try to fit some of the tomatoes in his beard.
Did the beard get in the way, maybe?
Well, both of them that lost had beards. So
wow. It's a feeding obstacle, Maddie.
Yeah, so if you want to come out here, you want to guarantee your way to victory, the way that we have seen here thus far through almost 1 hour, still a whole another hour for you to come out here and try it, is if you have a beard, shave it off.
Yeah, that's right. That's part of the strategy
of feeding. I'm pretty sure, even if you're not home, just go to the Dollar General, get a shave. Yeah, it's going to look bad, but you're going to get Cowboys and Chiefs tickets.
Well, as I was told by Lance, who's our representative that is kind of running this, you've got to get all the food in your mouth in 90 seconds or less. Any leftover condiments on the Flavor Saver beard, you got to get that stuff in the mouth, too.
That is a DQ.
Flavor Saver is not part of the mouth.
No, it's not.
Once you put your lips over the Flavor Saver and suck that good stuff back in, back in the mouth. So, I mean, this is all of this. See, these are the things you got to think about if you're going to be a professional feeder.
Yes.
We've got people like Joey Chestnut.
He's got it down to a science. He has strategy. Now, the thing that's disgusting that I did try that Joey Chestnut does, and you see him all dunking with the sliders, I tried it. And it was the worst thing of all time. Soggy, wet bread. And you're trying to go fast. They're like – and you can't just, like, throw that one away and grab a new one. No, they make you still eat it. So you still had to finish the whole slider and then go back.
Please don't do that with a thick burger. You're going to have mayonnaise and pickles floating around in your
water. Oh, that's right. It's got mayonnaise in it, too.
877-377-6963. The best act of feeding you've ever accomplished in your life. Your favorite international beers. It is an International Beer Day. And favorite smells of summer. Sports as well. We'll get into the NFL in the second hour with Bo Marchant, contributor to SI and the Sports Exchange and CBSSports.com. Stay with us on a Friday and be hungry and come visit us at Hardee's in Springdale.
Checking in again at Harry Robinson's Salisaw Ford, 1 mile south of exit 308 off I-40 in Salisaw. More for your trade, back-to-school specials, a lot going on, and a brand-new showroom floor that was recently redone. It's more comfortable than ever before to come to Salisaw Ford.
Yes, we just had our grand reopening sale, which went awesome last month. Thank you guys so much for your business. We appreciate it. We really do. Come down here and see what we have going on this month. I mean, right now, we've got the back-to-school giveaway going on. If you buy a vehicle from us, it does not matter if it is new or used, car, truck, van, SUV. It doesn't matter. Your name gets put in a drawing for $500.
Tommy Craft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-39.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite, white perch, slab, socolay, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Do you know the difference between admission and confession? Admission is acknowledging the truth of something. Confession is a formal statement agreeing that you're guilty. Greg Allman admitted he's no angel, but that doesn't mean he confessed his guilt before God. Romans 10:10 says, one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. Confess to God that Jesus died in your guilty place, and then you'll receive His amazing grace. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Pray about it. Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's Only One Way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view. It's a fact. And you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie.
I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
Storm today, or high this afternoon, into the upper 80s. Tonight, mainly clear, mid to upper 60s. Saturday, sunny skies, low to mid 90s. And then Sunday, just a slight chance of showers to storms across the north, highs near 95. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Weather is brought to you by Ramos Roofing, specializing in all roofing needs. 479-420-9903.
Good station.
KERX Paris Fort Smith. This is Halftime, coming at you from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
I love Arkansas! I love everything here! Give me that thing here!
Your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
And this one belongs to the Razorbacks.
Streaming live from
HitThatLine.com. Go crazy at Ball Walker! Go nuts!
This is Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious...
Your Razorbacks are 2021 SEC champions, and Baum Walker Stadium is an insane asylum.
I have been waiting for this moment for a long time.
Judging by the sound of it, so has everyone else.
Hey, hold on, it's almost halftime.
We've made it to the last hour of the week on Halftime. For me, this is just a weekend of shows for me, essentially.
I was about to say, you've barely been here.
I did no work
this
week.
Me and Maddie was carrying the show all week and parts of last week.
I feel like maybe I should do a couple hours of radio Saturday.
We knocked it out of
Sunday.
The park, and that's a baseball reference for you, Phil.
You're right. We hit a home run, as one would say.
I would call it a grand salami.
Maddie, was this week a tale of two halves for you?
It was. It was like a tale of two halves, a tale of four quarters.
Mm-hmm. This is why everybody's got their own reason for why they're excited about football. Some people just love to, you know, just to plan their day, you know, their whole week around the game. And some people just love to watch game after game after game. Some like to go watch a high school game Friday, mm-hmm. college game Saturday. And if they can make it to an NFL game on Sunday, do the same thing.
Well, it's great because you can watch football 6 out of 7 days. The only day that you can't really watch football is Wednesday.
There are no Wednesday games.
There are no Wednesday
games. None at all?
No, because Monday you got Monday Night Football. Tuesday you got the Maction. No games on Wednesday. Thursday Night Football, high school football, college football Saturday, and obviously NFL Sunday.
Well, Matty loves football season because he can begin to use the analysis of it was a tale of two halves.
That's right.
Okay.
Which he wasn't able to use at all during baseball season.
You can use it in basketball season, though.
Yes, you can. But football comes first.
That is true.
So it was a tale of 9 innings is what I told him. Because 4.5 innings, I think, was the direction he wanted to go a few times. All right, we've got Bo Marchant joining us later at the bottom of this hour. Covers the Steelers. And he is a scout in the CFL.
Yes, he is.
For the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. He's really put a living together from various aspects here of, well, I mean, Canadian football is not the same sport as American football,
no,
right?
No, it's not.
It's on a larger field.
Rules are kind of different. I mean, the premise of the sport is the same, but there are
different get to the end zone with the ball
and the field the goal post is still at the front of the is still on the goal line in the CFP.
Interesting.
Or not CFP, the CFL.
Interesting. And I remember the exact year the NFL moved the goal post to the back of the end zone, but you used to see some of these highlight videos
I've
from the 60s
them,
and stuff.
You
say, wow, that's so funny. Dude's still on the ground, by the way. You might not want to be laughing anymore.
That's true.
You know, when I grew up a football fan in the 80s, the hard hits were a massive marketing aspect mm-hmm. of the game. Now it isn't. It can't be any longer.
Because of all the stuff that we know about happens post-hit. We know about the CTEs, the concussions, and the head trauma that these players will most likely have going forward. And you still, as a football fan, want to see those hits. That's still a part of the game. And the players know that. The players signed up for it. You know, they knew going forward. I mean, everybody who's played the sport, for the most part, knew what they were signing up for, knew what they were getting in for, knew that there was a possibility of getting injured and from a big hit. So it still belongs in the game. Maybe not headhunting like it might have used to be, but big hits and explosive plays still belong in football and definitely in the National Football League. But you have to look at it a little bit more cautiously.
The difference is that the game used to be partially marketed on the violence, on the hits. I mean, how long? It wasn't even that long ago. I don't remember the segment that was run on ESPN. I think it was on primetime. About the biggest hits of the of a Sunday, and I mean that is marketing the violence of the game in a way that I remember in the 80s when NFL Films would put out Collision Course or Crash Course. I don't remember exactly the series of 30-minute videos they put out that basically just sold the violence,
one concussion
and the
after
incredible
another.
Hits that you would see over the middle that no longer are even allowed to be part of the game. I heard John Lynch talking about this on a podcast with Peter King recently. And of course Lynch was one of the biggest hitters of the 90s and the early part of the 2000s, and he talked about how when he played and he learned a lot of the position from Ronnie Lott.
Yeah,
when Lynch played at Stanford under Bill Walsh, Lott was still playing for San Francisco, and he would come in and he would work with John Lynch and some of the other Stanford safeties.
I mean, if there's somebody you're going to learn from, Ronnie Lott's a pretty good teacher.
Pretty good. Now then. Lynch talked about the quote-unquote dirty hit going over the middle on a receiver was at the legs. You know, those were the money makers. Mm-hmm. You don't go after somebody's legs, so they would hit him up high. You know, now you're not allowed to hit up high any longer. And going after the legs is
still a no-no.
You know, and it may be viewed a little bit differently. So that whole target that you're going at is so much smaller than before.
It's about EA big. Right,
and
about
doesn't
there.
Even take into account when a receiver is going after a ball and might have to – you know, lower his head a little bit. Yeah. So, anyway, I mean, it's just one of the aspects of football that has changed so dramatically. And, Michael in Fort Smith reminds me the segment was jacked up. That's right. Do you remember, Michael, I don't know how old you are, but if you might remember the Crash Course videos, they were on VHS. So that tells you how old it was. This was before DVDs came out. So be kind, rewind, and make sure you put that 30-minute video back to the start where Steve Sable would start talking about the biggest hits of the year in the NFL. Like this was I remember that video being the centerpiece of a sleepover party I had. I think when I turned 10 and I had my friends come over to the house and we all rented videos and we rented Young Sherlock Holmes was one of the movies. Maddie, you've ever seen that one?
Sorry, which one was that?
Young Sherlock Holmes.
Yes, I haven't seen that since I was a kid though.
Yeah, we had that one.
I haven't seen it.
Not a bad movie, actually.
Okay. Don't put it on the list.
And we watched Crash Course. And that, I mean, that was the one where, I mean, the room you were all going to sleep in was right above my parents' bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that was when my father had to come upstairs and tell us to shut up.
Yeah. That was the big keep it down up there type of situation. Yeah. Because the hits were probably so bad. So huge and so powerful that I'm guessing there was a lot of ohs. Coming from upstairs.
Did you see the Carolina Panthers defensive back that was waived after making I don't know if it was helmet to helmet, but it was deemed an unacceptable hit. Yeah, Keith Kirkwood was hit in the neck by JT Ibe, a rookie cornerback who was then released the next day by Matt Rhule for what he termed an unacceptable hit. Now, obviously, that hit probably goes along with, if it's a game, a penalty. Maybe an ejection.
Fine.
You know, but he's not doing it on one of his own players at that time, so he's been released because of this hit.
And that's something you would never see 20 years ago.
Absolutely.
It's something you wouldn't see 10 years ago.
JT in Hot Springs remembers Sports Illustrated sending in the VHS tapes with the big hits. That's right. And, of course, you got your football telephone.
Phone, yep.
Yeah, you got your football phone and your choice of a T-shirt of your favorite NFL team.
See, I'm old enough to remember actual Sports Illustrated magazines, of course. My father was had his own.
They still print it now, right?
I don't think they print it anymore. I think it's only online.
Well, they have a swimsuit issue, but I noticed they had like four different covers this time, and they were trying to be really inclusive.
Well, the swimsuit issue was the issue that basically kept the whole company afloat.
Oh yeah, that's the one you buy it for.
Which now it makes me wonder exactly who they're marketing to, because let's be honest, a lot of the guys were just going for the you know, they're trying to get stimulated by it.
And, well, and they still have plenty of good sports writers, but that whole thing's changed a bit. And, of course, the company started to go downhill when they stopped offering the giant football phones with your subscription.
Mm-hmm. On the flip side of the SI swimsuit model, there was also the Playboy All-Americans. So they tried to market to both crowds. So SI just took a page out of Hugh Hefner's book.
And Hef was there in his glorious smoking robe and had his cigar out there as well. And yep, and then all of the great college football. There have been some of those college players that weren't even allowed to pose for the photo because of the school. Might have been a case at Arkansas, I think, back in the 80s.
So I've had this conversation with one of the with a guy named Joe Allison. He was the kicker at the University of Memphis, and he was voted a Playboy All-American. And his biggest complaint wasn't that he didn't get to see any of the girls. It's that they took him out somewhere in Arizona to do the photo shoot and all that
stuff. Not at the mansion.
And he didn't get to go to the mansion.
Mm. That's exactly what you would be going for there. You know, a visit to the Playboy Mansion nowadays
means a lot less than
it did back in those days. 877-377-6963. Alan and Harrison gave us his favorite summer smells. Honeysuckle, fresh-cut grass.
I like honeysuckle
smell. Oh, that is a good smell.
And sweat from a place that might involve some cleavage. Only thing I can get into on that one. B.E. in Clarksville wants to pop a top of Corona Extra for his favorite international beer.
What's more authentic, you know, in Mexican than a Corona?
That's right.
Hey, they are really cheap, though.
About as authentic as Foster's in Australia.
It's domestic.
I've been to Mexico, and nope, they don't even think they sell those in Mexico.
They do. I know my buddy has been there plenty of times, and he says they're cheap.
Be an authentic feeder and come meet us at 401 South Thompson. Hardee's in Springdale. Down a third pound Angus Thick Burger. 90 seconds or less and you're qualified. Entered for the Hardee's 16th Annual Football Trip of the Lifetime, August 21st. Back on Halftime next.
Mahomes retreats, steps up into the pocket, he throws it late for the end zone, Kelce wide open, touchdown!
The Kansas City Chiefs.
Fires it to Edelman, a drop, that's intercepted, off of Edelman and picked by the Honey Badger, pick six!
Are back. Saturday, August 14th, the Chiefs kick off the preseason against the 49ers in San Francisco. Catch all the action here on your home for Kansas City Chiefs football.
Only on ESPN 95.3.
This time of year is hectic, and we know you have things to do and places to be. Southern Tire Mart can help you get there and save you money on America's most trusted brands like Michelin and BF Goodrich. Take advantage of our $29.95 oil change, which includes a 27-point vehicle inspection. Come see us at Southern Tire Mart just off I-540 at Exit 14 in Fort Smith today for quality Michelin and BF Goodrich tires and the best-in-class service. Get where you need to be with Michelin, BF Goodrich, and Southern Tire Mart.
Get a $100 Visa gift card when you make the move to Dish with World of Wireless. Call 877-305-DISH.
Call WOW now, 877-305-DISH. You have less than a week to take advantage of this offer. Get new Dish system installed in your home, up to six TVs installed for free with a $100 Visa gift card that you can use on anything, but it ends on August 12th. So you got to sign up by August 12th. We can install you the following weekend, but you do need to get signed up and call us or come by our store in Barling right next to Frank Row Furniture.
And Dish has the best equipment, the Hopper system, whole home DVR, the Dish Anywhere app. Lots of great reasons to make the move to Dish.
And the voice remotes. You get voice remotes in every single room. And the Hopper is a 4K ready receiver, so you can watch some of the events in 4K as they come out, like the Olympics and all those new sporting events.
And best of all, a two-year price guarantee.
The price won't change for 2 years, but you got to call WOW now, 877-305-DISH.
All right, get installed before the weekend's up, but you got to call the number Ben just gave you, 877-305-DISH for World of Wireless, your local Dish dealer. Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
My name is Adam Gray. I have so far lost 32 patients to COVID-19, and I've consoled people who contracted the virus and gave it to a loved one who then died. And this is breaking my heart. A very large percentage of the people in Arkansas right now that are being hospitalized are under the age of 40 and almost exclusively unvaccinated. We need this to end.
Get your vaccination. Learn more at healthy.arkansas.gov. This message brought to you by the Arkansas Department of Health.
In sports, if you think joy only happens after you win, think again.
Look at the world's most successful athletes like Serena Williams, Brooks Koepka, and Alex Morgan. They don't spend all their days grinding away. They take time to enjoy themselves, like getting together with friends over a Michelob Ultra, because they know that happiness is the key to winning and that joy is the whole game, not just the end game. Michelob Ultra. 95 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Needing your roof repaired? Ramos Roofing is a local company that has over 25 years of experience specializing in your residential or commercial roofing needs in the Oklahoma area. Ramos Roofing, a company you can trust. Offering discounts to senior citizens, law enforcement, or healthcare workers and assist in your insurance claims. Ramos Roofing, standing behind their work so you can stand under it. Call 479-420-9903. That's 420-9903. Ramos Roofing, working with you to build a better home.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Long distance information, give me Memphis, Tennessee. Help me find the party, try to get in touch with me. She could not leave.
You're listening to Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett. Want to jump in the conversation with the guys? Call or text into Halftime at 877-377-6963.
We're looking for a fourth winner qualifier. There's a difference winning and qualifying. Like you qualify for the Olympics by winning or at least finishing somewhere
trials,
in the Olympic trials, right? But you don't win until you do something in the actual Olympics. Then you're the winner. So this is a difference. This would be the qualifying round for the 16th annual football trip of a lifetime. We're here for another 45 minutes at 401 South Thompson in Springdale, which also means you got another 45 minutes at any of the Hardee's locations in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, and Salisaw to get a buy one, get one free Thickburger up until 1 o'clock. You get a buy one, get one free until 1 o'clock at any of those Hardee's locations. But here in Springdale,
you can get three for the price of one. I mean, you try to qualify, then you go buy your own burger and you get the free one. Three Thickburgers for the price of one.
And you just probably won't eat for the rest of the day.
You're good. Got the rest of your
meals. You won't
need
covered.
No, you won't, because you have three burgers.
Been asking for your favorite summertime smells, your favorite international beers. Andy in Mountain Home loves the smell of that first starting a two-stroke outboard boat motor. So, it's the smell of the first smell of combustion on a lake. Exactly what he's getting at there.
Oh, that's a good smell. Lake water lakes and rivers have their own unique smell, and none of them smell the exact same, but that'd be a big summer smell.
Fresh mud.
Yes.
Fresh mud that you're walking in with bare feet.
I was about to say, that's probably one of the best feelings, walking through lake mud just on a nice hot day, just kind of
out there. That doesn't smell like mud.
You can't smell it, but it's a good feeling in between your toes.
When it's
bug spray.
Around.
Bug spray is a pretty pervading citron summer smell.
That's more of a negative smell.
Citronella.
I don't think anybody likes the smell of bug spray.
Even the stuff they try to, infuse with citrus smells?
You can still smell it.
Yeah. All right. This is a Friday. I don't think we've done it this week, but we do have, I think this is one that's gotten a lot of publicity over the last few days or so. Here's our weekly Alexander Dumas of the week.
And I was wondering what Dumas would make of all this.
Come again.
Alexandre Dumas. He wrote The Three Musketeers.
Are you stupid or something?
Are you stupid?
I don't think so, no.
Did you eat a lot of paint chips when you were a kid?
Stupid is as stupid does, sir.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. God have mercy on your soul.
What was supposed to do, you moron?
Calm down. Have some dip.
Are you crazy or just plain stupid?
Thomas says stupid is as stupid does.
So you're a smart man who said some really stupid things.
Count of Monte Cristo by Alexandre Dumas.
Dumas. You know what that's about?
We're talking about our idiot kicker who got liquored up and ran his mouth off.
Y'all so stupid!
And if you've been online any time recently, you've seen the story of Maxwell Wilkinson Berry, 22-year-old flying on Frontier Airlines from Philadelphia to Miami. Oh gosh! I mean, he touched one of the flight attendants.
That's a no-no.
On her breasts.
Yeah,
a couple of times.
That's a big no-no.
That's a big no-no
anywhere, let alone in a plane.
Never alone. Yeah, on a plane where the laws are just a little bit tighter. Yeah. And
that's assault, brother.
It really is when it comes down to it. So they try to, you know, at least get him to a point where he is not shouting at people. So, I mean, we're not playing the video that everybody saw, which was this kid just shouting at the workers on the airplane about how much his family is worth and what's going to happen to these people because his grandfather's an attorney and this.
You always hate that. Do you know who I am? You know who my dad is?
It's the rich kid. And there's a difference between do you know who I am and do you know who my grandfather and my daddy are? I mean, that kind of thing. So, I mean, the kid, you're watching the video and you're like, somebody needs to punch this kid or
exactly.
At least, like, you know, shut him up. And the next thing you see is him getting duct taped into a seat, complete with mouth, with his mouth.
You got to.
Shut. How many people have you wanted to do this to in your life?
At least 100 people, probably.
And, of course, the flight crew got suspended by Frontier Airlines because
technically that's a no-no as well.
Right. But Maddie found a video of one of the members of the flight crew. Maddie, was she explaining herself?
No, it's a gentleman named Alfredo Rivera. And he is very colorful in his description of what happened. And this is from a local news report. And there's one word that they didn't bleep out that I'm going to hit the button real quick when he says it. But I'll just let this – I'll let him explain, should I?
Yes.
Please do.
And we'll test your timing as well. Okay.
The man to his seat. Ever since masks were required on airplanes, flight attendants say that their work has become downright dangerous.
Now, understand something. I'm a flight attendant. That means I attend the flights. Sometimes our job has us attending to crazy people. If you push us too far, you're going to have to attend this ass whooping. You see, because on this particular flight, I'm sitting in the jump seat, and I'm just looking at him like the damn fool. He's spitting and cussing and going crazy. I say, that's enough. I got up and I walked over there. And by the way, this man smelled like a pack of Marlboro cigarettes, 4 shots of Everclear alcohol, and regret. So I know something's about to go down. At this point, he touching all over my coworker's breast. And where he at is when he touched my ass. Because I don't play that. So what I did is I took out the duct tape. I said, he got scared, start stuttering, say, hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right. I said, yeah, we about to mummify your ass now, boy. So we wrapped him up. Better than any Christmas present you ever see. He won't be coming on no more Frontier flights at all.
Can I tell you maybe the best part about it? Like, that, there's a lot to unpack in that bit. His imitation of the sound of duct tape is priceless.
He got real quiet.
There is no way that he has ever pulled out duct tape on the airplane before. But that's just
I wonder what the purpose of the duct tape is on an airplane.
Oh, you always got to have duct tape.
Well, sometimes you just need something to hold the plane together. That sounds like a pig. That sounds like a hog.
Yeah, but it's a pretty good sound. I mean, you know, if somebody makes that sound, you either think pig or who's got duct tape.
I think that might be, like, the next time we need to shut up one of our guests, just play that sound.
Yeah.
Automatically. And then duct tape their mouth to shut. Because that's
mummify your ass now, boy. So we wrapped him up.
Oh, my gosh. He's a hero, by the way.
Wow.
I mean, this group of flight attendants really, for me, are heroes.
When's he going on tour, and is he coming anywhere near here? I will buy a ticket just to hear him tell the story and maybe extend it, make it a 5 to 10 minute long story. I'll go buy a ticket.
Can maybe Dodger Stadium hire the flight crew?
Oh, they need to. Somebody's
to work security for baseball games on the upper deck at Dodger Stadium. I mean, these fans at Chavez Ravine have always got
I mean, be. This guy to me is a bigger hero than that Sullenberger guy.
Yes.
He
might as well have landed the plane on the Hudson because that was brilliant.
Well, I mean, I saw the videos. I mean, and I feel like Dodger fans have had a special place anyway. This is where, it's just a few years ago, a Dodgers fan shot and killed a Giants fan.
Right outside the stadium.
I saw a video of Dodger fans throwing garbage trash cans, plastic trash cans with the Astros there, at Astros fans in the upper deck, but at the same time, there's so many more Dodger fans around them, they're just throwing all this stuff on Dodger fans, including
Children.
Two babies that were sitting there just a few rows in front of them. Like, here's a bit of advice. Anybody listening that ever thinks, you know what, I'm going to pick up this thing that's right here in front of me at this stadium, at this game I'm watching, and I'm going to throw it. And I'm going to throw it down in the direction of the field. Here's a little bit of advice. Don't.
Yes.
Don't do it. Don't smell like four packs of Marlboros, four shots of Everclear, and what was the other word? Regret.
Regret.
Because you will smell like regret probably for the rest of your life after that
moment. Be anti-Nike. Just don't.
877-377-6963. I told you I got kicked out of a Pittsburgh Penguins game once.
You did tell me that.
Just because a friend said something nasty to a policeman who was working security there. We didn't throw anything. Throwing something's going to get you kicked out quickly. Certainly here at Hardee's, that would be the same. If you don't complete the Thickburger eating contest in 90 seconds.
When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-39.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland. America's favorite, white perch, slab, socolay, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Do you know the difference between admission and confession? Admission is acknowledging the truth of something. Confession is a formal statement agreeing that you're guilty. Greg Allman admitted he's no angel, but that doesn't mean he confessed his guilt before God. Romans 10:10 says, heart, one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. Confess to God that Jesus died in your guilty place, and then you'll receive His amazing grace. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Pray about it.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's Only One Way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view. It's a fact. And you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Do you know the difference between admission and confession? Admission is acknowledging the truth of something. Confession is a formal statement agreeing that you're guilty. Greg Allman admitted he's no angel, but that doesn't mean he confessed his guilt before God. Romans 10:10 says, heart, one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. Confess to God that Jesus died in your guilty place, and then you'll receive his amazing grace.
beginning because they see the benefits of an active lifestyle. We're also always meeting new customers who are taking their first steps towards making running or walking a part of daily life. We have the opportunity to share in their successes and help them achieve their goals. The people of Fort Smith and the River Valley are why we believe we were voted one of the best running stores in America. Visit us and see how we can help you. True Grit Running Company, 6808 Rogers Avenue, Suite B, behind Chick-fil-A.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Make sure to follow Halftime on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine. Follow the guys on Twitter at PhilElsonPXP, at Matt Travis, and at DBarrett36. Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
Here at Hardee's for another 30 minutes at 401 South Thompson in Springdale. We just had our fourth person to down the Thickburger in 90 seconds or less. He's qualified for a seat at the table at the 16th Annual Football Trip of a Lifetime, August 21st. And we still have another 30 minutes at all of the Northwest Arkansas, River Valley, and Salisaw Hardee's locations. You can get a buy one, get one free Thick Burger up until 1 o'clock. Going to get into the NFL. First NFL game played yesterday. It was the Hall of Fame game between the Steelers and the Cowboys.
Nice to have football back, but to be honest, it was a little boring.
It's back, though.
It's back,
not every game
it's
is going to be fully exciting.
Especially the Hall of Fame game where neither one of the starting quarterbacks were even there.
Right. Bo Marchand covers the NFL. At college2pro.com, footballinsiders.com, a contributor to cbssports.com, and a good NFL draft nick as well. Bo, how you doing today? Drew said that the Hall of Fame game yesterday was boring. I'm a Steelers fan. I kind of agree. What do you think?
Well, before we talk football, I got to know, can you guys meet the Hardee's Challenge? Do you guys qualify for the burger?
No, we do not,
unfortunately.
No.
We've been going back and forth to see if we think we can do it. Phil doesn't think he can do it.
No, I know I can't do it.
I think I might be able to do it if they'd let me take the tomato off, Bo, because I don't like raw tomato.
My thing, Bo, is I'm too slow of an eater. I think I could make a thick burger last for the entire 2 hours of the show. So I go in a different direction. I would imagine don't you think, like, every NFL player? I mean, these guys are eating machines. They could eat. We had a texter said he ate a double thick burger plus the fries and the drink in 80 seconds. That sounds like an NFL player to me.
That's pretty impressive. Yeah. Well, you know what? Listen, last night, Tom Benson Pro Football Hall of Fame Stadium, it was a packed house, 21,000 max capacity, fans in the stands, the press box was packed. It was the most, pre-COVID existing sports event that I've been to, since we've been under this pandemic condition. So the game might not have been fantastic, but most Hall of Fame games aren't. I like to say it's kind of like it's just a real, real precursor to, the preseason. It's just an extra little game that these guys get to go in. But I thought last night was fabulous. I think the big thing was, Najee Harris looked pretty good. And I've never remembered Tomlin really given a lot of credence or positivity in terms of really throwing a guy some love. And he did that last night in the presser, which, again, was really nice. You actually sat in the press room and Tomlin was at the podium. It wasn't a Zoom call. And, he said as much about Harris as everything that they've seen him do in practice, they were able to see last night. And he said he spoke to Harris and others that it wasn't about the spectacular play. He wanted to make the routine plays routine. And I think that's what he was most excited about as a coach and what the Steelers were able to do last night.
I loved Harris as a pick. And I still love the Steelers wide receiver pool, bringing Juju back, and Claypool's going to take a big step forward. I hope Deontay Johnson, stops dropping the ball. And Roethlisberger looks like he's you know, as light as he's been in a long time and hopefully very healthy, you know. But my aspect is the offensive line, you know, that was a problem for them last year. Might not even be as good as they were last year. So I just don't know what kind of holes there are going to be for Najee Harris. Give me a thought on the Steelers' offensive line. And, you know, yesterday is not necessarily what you go by, but, you know, that for me is the Achilles heel on the Steeler offense.
Well, you nailed it. I mean, that is the Achilles heel, and it was last year when it was an enormous. It was both Achilles. I mean, they had neither Achilles to work with. That's how bad that offensive line was. Yeah, if they want to see the Najee Harris they envisioned when they took him 27th overall in that draft, that offensive line is going to have to be cohesive and very productive. Tomlin, again, was kind of happy with the production last night. He liked the forward lean that they got. He liked that touchdown by Ballage and how they were kind of able to push that pile. But as you mentioned, it's preseason football. You don't want to get too excited. But I just think any positive progress, though, because the Cowboys are trying to do their thing as well. They're trying to execute their game plan. So I think anything positive that you can take out of practice or preseason football is something you have to say, hey, this is a good thing, and hopefully we can kind of make this work, you know, when they debut in the NFL opener. But again, you know it. That NFL line that they have, you know, no DeCastro, no Pouncey, that, you know, they got the, you know, a lot of shakeup amongst that line. And people, you know, some people say, oh, you know, DeCastro and Pouncey, you know, there was their time. There's not a real Steelers fan that really in their hearts would not want those two guys. Mm-hmm. Were they in their prime? No, but they felt comfortable. But this is the hand they're dealt. Both these guys are no longer on the roster. They elected retirement. But at the end of the day, I hope that they can get it resurrected. I always thought that line, I knew they were going to take, I shouldn't say I knew, but I really was confident in the idea. When Mike Munchak left to go to Denver, his daughter moved there. It wasn't a, you know, discrepancy with the Steelers. It was just a family choice. He wanted to be closer to her and the family that he elected, and he's now in Denver. And you see, I think Denver allowed 4 sacks or some crazy statistic last year compared to the years before. And when Munchak was at the helm of that line, that's when we saw some of the biggest success from it in recent years. So it's a matter of them finding that magic that Munchak left when it went off to the Broncos.
Mo, it was the first preseason game for both of these teams, and definitely for the Steelers. And, you know, Big Ben wasn't playing, and you try not to read too much into preseason, and then especially the first preseason game. But when Big Ben is eventually going to be gone, either this year more than likely or one extra year, do the Steelers really believe one of the three guys backing up Big Ben is the future? Do they really believe it's Rudolph or Dobbs, or that they can somehow re-erect Haskins' career so he doesn't join Jamarcus Russell as one of the biggest busts of all time?
You know, I think internally they do believe it, and I think that's the mindset of any team. I mean, if you bring a guy in, you think there's upside. I mean, do they think, you know, Mason Rudolph's going to end up, you know, having a Pro Bowl or Hall of Fame type career as Ben has, and, you know, thrown for, you know, top 5 yards, touchdowns, and play as long as it? I mean, I don't know if that's the expectation, but, you know, I think they bring these guys in with the hopes that they can pan out, and you want them to succeed to the highest level. But, I mean, we know that you have to be elite to get to that elite level, and very few can do that. So, you know, is the future of the quarterback, if you're a Steelers fan or that organization, you hope, you know, Rudolph, even Haskins, you know, find some life, or even Dobbs, you know, somehow gets them through, you know, the thick and thin if they need to. But at the end of the day, that's an unknown, and, you know, they're going to ride it out with Ben, and you just hope Ben plays 16 games. And if he doesn't, it, you know, you assume it's Rudolph's role. You know, that's going to be the guy I think they go to first. I think that's evident. But, you know, last night, I mean, they all showed a little something. You know, you watch Haskins. I mean, just his athletic ability. I mean, I know it was an overthrown pass, and you're like, well, you know, it wasn't accurate pass. But, I mean, he does some things, you know, with that ball in his hands when he throws it. I mean, he has pop. I mean, that thing bursts out of his hands. Granted, I mean, it doesn't matter if it's not going to where you need it to go. I mean, you just want a guy that can deliver the ball in a catchable way to the receiver. But, you know, if he can find some life, you know, for what they cost, it's, you know, low, you know, buy low, you know, maybe get it high, and, you know, and Haskins could be the guy. But right now it's Rudolph's role. And you guys, so we got a Steelers guy and a Ravens guy as hosts. Are you guys going to talk during game week?
Well, I'm wearing my Ravens hat right now.
I didn't even notice that.
Oh, really? Sure,
yeah.
You didn't.
I usually don't see the color purple on people's hats when they're black, so I couldn't quite tell what you were wearing there.
Oh, okay.
Is that the best rivalry in the NFL right now, Bo?
Oh,
or did it take a little bit of the back seat? Okay.
No, I think bar none. And this is my testament to why. And granted, I don't travel all across the nation, but last year during COVID conditions in Baltimore, maybe they had, I don't know, maybe 5,000 fans. It was one of the most hyped up atmospheres. I even came home and told friends that it might have been the best atmosphere I've ever experienced at a football game, and there was only 5,000 people in the stands. And I've been to pretty big games. I've been to some real barn burners, two high profile teams in college and pro. And that game, that atmosphere, I mean, they don't dislike each other, but they're both successful. They've had, the division titles. They have the Super Bowls in the last couple decades to prove their success. And they are the class act to me in terms of, that rivalry in the NFL. That not only do they dislike each other, but they're successful, and neither one of them really has an advantage. When they play, you don't know who's going to win, and that's the great thing about the rivalries. I mean, Michigan-Ohio State, I mean, it's not a rivalry anymore because Ohio State's won, 25 of the last 26, so you just kind of laugh at it. You just listen, it's like, eh. But these two teams and their success, I think that's why it's so important, and that's why when these two teams face each other twice a year, oftentimes even in the playoffs, you get such clashes.
Yeah, well, I remember you telling me last year about your experience at M&T Bank Stadium and the great reviews you were giving it. One big story, maybe not big, but it's been a talking point today out of the Hall of Fame game was what happened on the broadcast is Jerry Jones publicly said he was going to put Jimmy Johnson into the Ring of Honor. Do you find that that was a genuine, and what he's been saying is saying it was mostly his fault for breaking up the Jimmy Johnson era in Dallas, and it was selfish of him? Or do you think that, because I've seen both sides argue that it's really Jerry trying to be genuine and apologize, or it's just another way to turn the story back to Jerry? Where do you feel this one lands?
Well, I think it's long overdue, and I'm glad I think it's genuine that Jerry has recognized Jimmy Johnson for what he did for the Cowboys. And usually it's the team puts the guy in the Ring of Honor in their stadium, and then the Pro Football Hall of Fame follows suit. This is the opposite. The Pro Football Hall of Fame, the voters said, hey, this guy's a Hall of Fame coach. Maybe the Cowboys will kind of pick up on it and get on the bandwagon. And Jerry did. It was probably a little bit of public pressure and looking a little bit odd that, this Pro Football Hall of Fame coach is not in your Ring of Honor at, Dallas Stadium. So I think that pushed Jerry's hand to go that route, but I think it's genuine, and even deep down, maybe internally behind closed doors, if he has some resentment for whatever went wrong between their relationship, he'll keep that to himself. But publicly, I think he's doing everything the right thing, and I do think it's genuine. I think there's got to be a point where you say, hey, you know what, this guy, we won 3 Super Bowls basically since that time, from his, when he had the residue with Jimmy Johnson was on those Dallas Cowboys, they had the success, and since that time, I think since 2000, I mean, if you look at their record, I mean, it's playoff-wise, it's one of the worst. It's really, really bad since the departure of Johnson and everything that they created when they, they headed to Dallas together and created a dynasty, to be honest.
Well, we're talking about, too, the all-time great franchises in the NFL, in the Steelers and the Cowboys, not the Ravens.
No, thanks for throwing another punch there, Bill.
What about where do the Winnipeg Blue Bombers fit into the conversation in the all-time great teams in the CFL? Because I see that they've won 11 Grey Cups. It seems like quite a lot. You scout for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, a CFL team, and it sounds, very, very interesting. I think a lot of us view that the CFL gets the, those who can't make the NFL. Is that true? And what are you looking at as a scout? Are you looking for diamonds in the rough, that sort of thing?
Yeah, well, it is. I mean, and helping out with Winnipeg, it's been a fun experience because you think, hey, this guy, first thing is, most players, it's hard to get them to Canada. I mean, most guys really want that shot to play in the NFL. If you're an agent, you tell your guy, listen, the NFL phone might not ring, but you might be able to go up north. Some take that as an insult. So then you got to get them past that. And then there's other guys that they just want to play football anywhere. I mean, you could tell them they're going to play on Jupiter and they're not going to make it there for 3 years by the time the spaceship arrives. They'd sign up and go right now. So, it's a different avenue. You can only have so many Americans on the, you know, there's so many Canadians that have to be on the field every play. Like, you know, so there's some different things, but overall, you know, it's a high end, you know, football. I've seen it, you know, but at the end of the day, these guys really want that NFL career. And I don't blame, because that, you know, you sign one NFL contract, you know, if, even if you play a year, I mean, you know, you're going to make not life changing money, but the, you know, the pocket that you're going to have in the bank is going to be substantially higher than, you know, playing a career in the CFL. But it's a great experience. You know, I've been fortunate enough for those guys to kind of, you know, allow me to tag along. And in 2019, the last year, I mean, no COVID year in 2020, Winnipeg won the Grey Cup. But there was a long hiatus there, and it was nice to see, you know, winning football back and you know, being a little bit piece of it, I guess, if you want, just with my news and notes that I, you know, pass along and try to put my hand in the pile, if you will. But, you know, CFL football, thankfully it's back. You know, the season starts in August. Usually it starts in May, and they're going to be wrapping things up in November. So a little bit shortened COVID season, but nonetheless very thankful that it's back on course, considering there was no season at all in 2020.
Very cool. Well, it shows you're a football guy through and through, no matter the country that we're talking about here. Bo, I'm a Steelers fan, so I'm going to be following you now. And hopefully we can do this again sometime during the NFL season. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thank you. And I cannot wait till the Ravens and Steelers play. And I would love to see some video of that studio session that you guys giving each other the evil eye.
It's going to be tense.
It's a good thing that Drew and I usually do the show in separate studios in different cities. We might have to jump across the table at each other on those weeks. As Bo Marchand, college2pro.com covers the Steelers, scout for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, contributor at CBSSports.com. And you can give him a follow at Bo Marchant, last name spelled M-A-R-C-H-I-O-N-T-E. And we'll wrap up halftime after the break. Stay with us.
It is officially open. Wave Rural Connect for Arkansas Valley Electric Cooperative members north of Ozark, including Cass, Paradise, Batson, and others. To sign up, call 1-833-4-WAVE-RC or go online at signup.waveruralconnect.com. Fiber internet starting at $49.95 a month, TV $32.95, and phone $29.95. It's what you've been waiting for and more. Trust me, we love it. Arkansas Valley Electric and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is growing and looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building experience or you have welding skills, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay, health, dental, and vision benefits. Join the top fence building team in the state. The Fence Man. Apply today in person. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Make your car buying experience better at Hertz Car Sales. The goal is to provide customers with a wide selection of low-mileage, extra-clean vehicles, providing their buyers with a better way to drive. A professional sales staff, quality customer service, along with a relaxing atmosphere is what you find every time at Hertz Car Sales. What are you waiting for? Make the short drive to 2810 Midland Boulevard or call them today at 783-1722. You can also check them out online at buyfromhertz.com. Hertz Car Sales, when you're ready.
Are you in need of roofing repairs or maybe more? Construction Master Roofing, who has been under new management since 2019 with over 25 years of experience, is who you need to call. Estimates are free, and military, first responders, and medical workers receive 5% off. Construction Master Roofing guarantees their work, and the number you need to call is 648-8888 in the River Valley, and in Oklahoma, call 918-859-4714. Construction Master Roofing, the roofing company that cares and gets the job done.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
This is Brett Goode, former Razorback and Super Bowl champion with the Green Bay Packers. Everyone loves to be on a winning team. That is why I have joined Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions. Henderson Phillips can help you tackle all your employee benefit, health insurance, and staffing management solutions. Plus, I can help you with any commercial or personal insurance need. Come join my team at Henderson Phillips. Call me, Brett Goode, at 479-651-2292. That's 651-2292.
This is Bruce Stanton, Vice President and General Manager of Pradco Fishing in Fort Smith. Our number one volume lure out of our 20 fishing brands is the Bobby Garland Baby Shad. We make them by the millions in our facility in Fort Smith, and the Baby Shad is without a doubt the number one soft plastic crappie lure in the U.S. Fish it on a light jig head or underneath a float, and you'll find it's as productive as live bait. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Bobby Garland Baby Shad.
This is ESPN 95.3.
Hey, it's a big job just getting by with 9 kids and a wife. But I've been working, man, dang near all my life, and I'll keep on working.
You're listening to Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett. The Morning Rush, Halftime, Ruskin and Zach, Fantasy Football Sunday, and Primetime Preps. All available on the Hit That Line Podcast Network. Just type Hit That Line wherever you listen to podcasts. Our podcasts are on iTunes, Spotify, SoundCloud, HitThatLine.com, Anchor, TuneIn, Stitcher, and Google Play.
Big plans this weekend, Drew? You know anything going on?
I'm staying up here in the NWA, going to help my buddy do a little drywall, and then we're going fishing. A big fishing weekend for me.
These things go together, don't they? Drywall and fishing?
Well,
a little work, a little fun.
Exactly. In order for him to take me fishing, we got to finish up his work. So that's what I'm doing. We're going to finish up the drywall work. That way he doesn't have to do it over the weekend, and he takes me fishing. And I feel like that's a fair trade. He's going to pay me.
Like a really good weekend, Memphis.
Almost a fair trade. I'll take Memphis. I will take it.
He's not giving me side eye when
I'm
call
smiling.
Him.
No, he's proud of that, I think.
I am proud of my hometown, of my city.
As you should be.
Of my culture.
Matty, you've been Matty T forever. Has anybody ever given you another nickname?
Phil, early on in my career, I used to be called Big Baby. But I outgrew that name.
Matthew, you sure Big did. Baby Travis.
You sure did outgrow that
Spinning
name, Spinning
the
friend.
Dials, 3-6.
That's
got to
be like
radio.
Maybe 8-9 years ago.
There was another radio host at the station you used to work at whose nickname was Whipper with a piece of the anatomy thrown in front of that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you remember that one. That's one of the great radio nicknames I ever remembered. And for me, I was given a nickname in Ogden, Utah, working for a rookie baseball team that I cannot say on the radio. It would not be allowed to say, but it is I don't even know how I could describe this thing
flattered?
Without being – well, my name is Phil.
Uh-huh.
You put a D-O at the end of that. That was the nickname, okay?
Okay. Now I'm not going to be able to forget
that's
that.
A baseball – that's real baseball name nicknames
like,
for you, man. You know, here's the thing,
Matty,
though.
That's going to slip out of my mouth sometime in the next week. And especially like we were just talking about Ravens and Steelers week, that's all I'm going to say.
Just make sure it occurs during the other 22 hours that we're not on the radio.
Is that not FCC?
I don't know if it would be, but we – you know,
the sponsors may frown upon it.
Yes, sir, some of them
or
would.
Or they might think it's funny because we have cool sponsors.
Here was the problem with that nickname. Like, and I've always said this, and I had to teach Ty this, and I think SmackDown, too, if they're not making fun of you, they don't like you,
mm-hmm.
right?
Exactly.
In baseball, that's just the way it is.
100%.
So when the owner of the team started calling me that, I'm like, how am I supposed to take this? Because this is the
Very
guy
well.
That's
that
like,
means they like
me
you.
And gave me the job. But the funniest aspect of this was, like, sooner or later, and I was only there for 3 months, nobody's ever referred to me as that mm-hmm. since then. Even the Bat Boys. Who had no clue what the joke was, were calling me
How
that.
Old were the Bat
That's
Boys?
That's just
like
his
eight.
Name, you know?
They were like 8 or 9.
Like, you're like, yeah,
you are not supposed to be
Blake
talking
Elson.
Like this.
He's
well,
the
hopefully,
voice of the team.
Hopefully they put a mister in front of it.
Right, yeah.
Make it, like, that's Mr. Blake to you, sir.
That's right. You have to be very formal when you're talking to one of your older people, even when you're referring to them as their nickname and incredibly poor taste. Boy, been a lot of fun today. Hey, he's got plans. If you haven't made your plans yet, or even if you have, you need to involve 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge in Fort Smith. Great place to wrap the evening up, maybe with a great cigar, cap it off with a great drink, and they've got it all there at 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, plus great food. That's another way to wrap up the night. Open until 1 o'clock tonight and tomorrow. If you just go to their Facebook page, you'll find all of their specials and events. Tonight until midnight, the Don Bailey Trio featuring Logan Dooley on upright bass at 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, 906lounge.com, where you can find their menu.
He's right, playing upright bass?
That's right. A bass. I'm sorry. Ah. I'm too busy worrying about fishing. That's right.
It all ties in.
It's a bass when it's an instrument. It's a bass when it's
right.
a fish. It's spelled exactly the
it?
Same way.
That's
and this is the same
English
person.
Language.
This is the same
English
person
language.
That referred to crappies as crappies. The first time he ever saw that put on a script.
Crappies? What's a crappie?
Well,
it doesn't taste very good.
There's a lot of things that are crappies. It's just they're not fish. Yes, and Leonard likes upright bass. That was funny too. Upright bass. It is a bass. Drum, guitar, upright. Try to do that to a fish. It's not going to make music for
no,
you.
No, it's not.
Go through some of these texts here. After the upright bass comment here from Leonard, haha, yes. Maybe that could be my nickname, upright bass.
You can tune a piano, but you can't tune a fish.
No, the fish will always resist you on your ability to do that. Let's see here. B in from Clarksville wants you to have the mummify yo ASS part from that. From the flight attendant from Frontier Airlines. That was
has to be on the
I think that was my favorite part of the show today. Outside of seeing four of our six contestants down the Thickburger in 90 seconds or less. And I feel like that's an accomplishment for us.
That is an accomplishment for us. It shows that we truly bring the best people. The best people listen to us.
With the best appetites.
The best appetites. There's a reason we won the voting Olympics, which I'm still waiting on my tab for that.
That's true. We are owed some beverages.
Ty and Tommy have not brought it up
yet.
Yeah,
funny how that just disappeared, isn't
oh,
it?
Oh, I know. It was real fun and games until they lost.
Well, I think Ty's back on the air next week, so we can start that, Adam. We can definitely start
yes,
that with him. I like that one too, Justin. Tuna fish. That's a good nickname for a musician who calls the instrument a bass. We're back with you on Monday. For Drew, for Maddie, I'm Phil. Get up, get out, get better.
It's an all-new month, and there's all-new inventory at Harry Robinson's South Assault Ford, 1 mile south of exit 308 off.